My dear friends in Christ Jesus, today we have the first reading from the prophet Isaiah, and it starts by saying, "Shout for joy, O daughter Zion. Sing joyfully, O Israel." The prophet is asking us to be joyful as on days of feast or any celebrations. Say for example, during these days we are all happy, joyful, because it's Advent season, Christmas is coming. In the same way, we are expected to be happy and joyful always, because our God is with us and He has assured us His presence till the end of the world. And that's the reason that we need to be happy always. Coming to the gospel, we have two moms. It's a meeting of two moms, two mothers, Elizabeth and Mary. Both of them are pregnant. Only difference is Elizabeth is bearing a son in her old age, and Mary also is bearing a son in her teenage. So it's a meeting of, in a way, four people, four characters. Two moms, Mary and Elizabeth, are meeting together, and also two other babies, John the Baptist and Jesus, are meeting together. And it is said that when the two moms met together, both of them were filled with the Holy Spirit. And not only that, John the Baptist was filled with the Holy Spirit by the presence of Jesus in the womb of Mary. In the womb of Elizabeth, John leaped with joy. So when those true moms met each other, both of them are filled with the Holy Spirit. The point to reflect upon is, does our presence bring joy to someone whom we meet? We meet so many people. Sometimes the persons whom we meet, if we don't like them, sometimes we take another way. We don't want to meet them. Sometimes we have noticed there are people seeing us from away, they turn away to other place because they don't want to meet us. They don't want to talk us. Our presence should bring joy to others. When someone meets us, are they happy with our presence? When somebody meets us, can our presence be the cause for them to be filled with the Holy Spirit? Can our words, our appearance, our smile can bring happiness to others? Or when people invite us to some party or to some celebration, and when we arrive in their party or celebration, and when they meet us, are they happy with our presence? If we are filled with the Holy Spirit, people who meet us can experience that the empowering of the Holy Spirit. It is said in the Gospel, Mary, as soon as she received the message from angel Gabriel that she would become the mother of God, she did not sit quietly and spending time in her room. She also had received the message that Elizabeth, her cousin, is in her old age, is bearing a son, and she is already the sixth month. She believed it. As soon as angel Gabriel left the place, she became active, rather spending time in her home quietly. She became very active. She believed what the angel told her, and she went in haste to meet Elizabeth. See, Elizabeth is in her old age and Mary is in her teenager. And you see, who is greeting or who is taking initiative to greet? It's not Mary who is greeting, it is Elizabeth who is taking the initiative to greet first. You see, in sometimes when people meet, they come, oh, bless father. Or the younger ones get the blessing from the elder ones. But here, see the greatness of Elizabeth. She is in her old age. But then she is filled with the Holy Spirit by seeing Mary. And she is appreciating Mary, telling, oh my God, who is in front of me? Mother of God. Oh, Mother of, how blessed I am to see the Mother of God. Elizabeth is greeting Mary, a young girl. In our human language, if we say, Elizabeth could have become little envious, saying, oh, I am only the mother of John. You are mother of Jesus. Oh, but then here no envy, no jealousy. Rather, Elizabeth is filled with the Holy Spirit and greeting a young girl. Mother of God is in front of me. How blessed I am. And then in the following text, we see the singing of the song of Mary. Then after the greeting, Mary starts singing, praising God, thanking God. Oh God, how great you are, lowly. The lowly people are lifted. The humble are lifted up. Mighty God, we salute you, we praise you. My dear friends, during these days of Christmas, as we are almost concluding the Advent season, let us examine and see whether we are filled with the Holy Spirit. We meet so many people these days, but then can our presence bring joy to others?